Xin chào tất cả các bạn trẻ. Các bạn có muốn nghe và nói chuyện với Jack Ma không? Nghe không trả lời không rõ lắm. Các bạn có muốn nghe không? Tuyệt vời, tuyệt vời. Nhưng mà thay vì lời giới thiệu về Jack Ma thì tôi muốn các bạn xem một đoạn video clip ngắn về một huyền thoại sống. Video clip.
Jack Ma là một trong những người truyền cảm hứng cho công việc kinh doanh của mình.
Alibaba đã truyền cảm hứng cho tất cả các doanh nghiệp, không chỉ ở Trung Quốc, không chỉ trên thế giới mà ngay cả các doanh nghiệp Việt Nam. Hơn 100.000 doanh nghiệp Việt Nam đã xuất khẩu được nhờ Alibaba. Hàng trăm ngàn người Việt Nam, doanh nghiệp Việt Nam nhập hàng từ trên những cái hệ thống của Alibaba về Việt Nam để kinh doanh.
Ông ấy còn thất bại hơn mình rất nhiều lần, nhưng bây giờ ông ấy là một tỷ phú. Vậy thì mình mới thất bại một lần thì tại sao mình lại không thể trở thành một người như ông ấy?
Thì mình mong muốn trở thành một người sếp cũng có hài hước như Jack Ma, để có thể vừa hiểu tâm lý nhân viên, không có uy quyền mà thúc đẩy được họ làm việc tốt hơn.
Và bây giờ tôi rất mong các bạn đứng dậy. Và các bạn vỗ tay thật to để nhiệt liệt chào mừng Chủ tịch Tập đoàn Alibaba Jack Ma. Jack Ma recently makes a kung fu movie, and I would like to ask him to teach me a little bit how to do the kung fu. Can you do this a little bit? Just few.
Wow.
I'm just it's my hobby so for play tai chi, right? Just once, okay?
Yeah. Bravo.
Thank you
very much.
Thank you.
Great.
Thank you.
Great.
Thank you.
Yeah, please deliver your Thank speech.
You. Well, good afternoon everyone. It's my great honor to be invited. I've been looking forward to this opportunity to communicate with young people, entrepreneurs, students for a long time. And thanks to Prime Minister's invitation in Davos, he said, Jack, please come to Vietnam, spend some time with the young people, share your experience of doing business. So I came 2 nights ago. In the evening, I walk around the streets on Hanoi. I'm very inspired because there's so many young people in this country. And they are always great smile, energetic, and they're all playing all kinds of games on the street. I was wondering why people in Vietnam are so happy. One of the reasons I think is because you are very young. Young people. But the great thing is that young people, if they are happy for the future, if they are optimistic for the future, and that means they are optimistic for their country. So today, I come here to share some of my ideas how to do business. Like most people here, I'm not, I was not born in a rich family. I don't have a rich father. I don't have a powerful uncle. And I don't have anything. I failed many, many times in school, in finding jobs. But I think this is all the great experience I have. Because I fail, I learn things from the mistakes. I learn things from my failure. So even today, Alibaba is very big, but we still believe there are a lot of mistakes, a lot of failures ahead of us. When we meet this kind of failures, mistakes, I never worry, because I know life is full of mistakes. Life is full of failures. If people say, you know, nobody help me, when we do business, you always want people to help you. But if there's no people to help you, don't worry. Because no people help you, this is very natural. People help you, this is unnatural. Because there's no reason why people should help you. I think if you want to open a right business, a good business, you should pick up a right time with the right people. Right time, I think today the whole world for doing business is a right time. We are at the time of the third technology revolution. Every technology revolution takes about 50 years. The first 20 years is about pure technology. Next 30 years is about application or implication of the technology. So internet has just passed 20 years. The next 30 years, those people who make full use of the internet in their business, in their life, those people will be successful. I feel that next 30 years, the artificial intelligence, next 30 years, many things will change, especially in the business community. Right? For example, the old way we do business in the past 100 years is called a B2C. In the future, is C2B. Consumer to business. Last century is called IT technology. This century is called data technology. It's called DT technology. And last century, because of globalization, only helped 20% of the developed countries. Globalization only helped 20% of the big companies. This century, the business is going to focus on 80% of the small business. This century, because of new technology, we have to rely a lot of the young people. So I think those countries, if they have a lot of young people, if they rely on young people, if they really give the trust on the young people, those are the countries has the great hope. Every country I go, I talk to the government. Please pay special attention to the following. Please pay special attention to the next 30 years. Because the next 30 years are the most important years in the humankind. Please pay attention to those young people who are below 30 years old. Please pay attention to the companies who have fewer than 30 employees. Because small business will be the driver of this century. Last century, big companies, big size, big money, these companies will be successful. This century, those companies who are small, who are flexible, who are innovative, who are creative, who are constructive, these people will be successful. These companies will be successful. The other thing is about the right people. If you want to build up a good business, you have to have a good team. And the good team is the most important. And find the right people, not find the best people. There is no best people outside your company. All the best people are the people you hire them, you work with them, you train, you develop together with them. So I think for doing business, the most important thing is not money. The most important thing is you have a great idea and find a group of people who share the same idea with you. Nobody alone, one person, you can run very fast. But if you want to run for a long time, you have to go together with a lot of people together. So in my company, we focus a lot on the young people. We focus a lot on the teamwork. 18 years ago, 18 founders in my apartment, we had a dream that we believe internet is going to be very powerful. We believe internet is going to be the technology to help many small business. We believe e-commerce will be the future of doing business online. Because we believe this, so I invited many young people who believe the same idea with us. So, right time, right people. And the third is very important, is that you always have to know that any successful business takes long time to realize. There is no successful business that you will do today and succeed tomorrow. There's no such opportunity. There is no opportunity that you do today, you win next year. No. For people like us in this room, most of the 99.9% of people, remember, if you want to do something today, you should say, I will be successful in 10 years. In next 10 years, I will continue to do it, improve it with many people. It only takes 10 years I can succeed. So if you want to do something that you do today, succeed next year or next month, there's no such opportunity. So based on this right time, right people, and prepare for 10 years, and the next thing is, as entrepreneur yourself, you should be optimistic for the future. We should believe in future. No matter what, you remember, if you not succeed, somebody will be successful. And also remember one thing, that I found a lot of successful people in this world. Warren Buffett, Bill Gates, Steve Jobs, I met all of them. I found one good quality they have, that they never complain. I found a lot of people around me, they always complain, this is no good, this is not good, this is not ready, and I don't have money, I don't have relationship. Those people will never have opportunities. Where is the opportunity? Opportunity only exists in the place where most people complain. When other people complain, that's the opportunity. Solve the problems. Solve the complaints. And then you have the chance. And the other thing is that I would say is that we always have to learn from the mistakes the other people make, not necessarily learn from the successful stories. A lot of MBA schools today, they focus on learning successful stories. To be successful, there are a lot of reasons, but to fail, there are only a few reasons. You have to learn the story why people fail. In the past 18 years, together with my team, we pick up any failure stories that the other people make. We study, we learn, and we try to avoid it. Actually, you learn from the mistakes, not because you can avoid the mistakes, because you know what will you be when you really meet these mistakes and failures. Right. So this is something I want to share, but very important. All the other thing is that people, if you want to do something, you should have an idea. You should have a dream. The idea is about what are the things that you can do the other people cannot do. What are the things that you can do better than the others? What are the things that you can do differently from the others? When most people say this, you should think about why not that. When most people say that, you should think about why not this. You have to be different. If you are the same like others, why you have the opportunity? Right. So this is how my experience. And I was told that there are some books about me, about Alibaba in Vietnam, which is very popular. I don't read them because in the future that I want to write a book of myself is Alibaba 1001 Mistakes. There are a lot of mistakes. All the young people, if you learn from the mistakes, you will be stronger. You will be realistic. Only when you see all the mistakes, when you see all the failures, you still want to fight the future. You have the chance. And the other thing I want to share with you is that nobody is Superman. If you want to be successful, you have to be realistic. You have to focus. You have to work with team. You have to be optimistic for the future. This is all I can share with you, and I will be ready to answer any questions you have. Because I don't want to tell you that I'm smart than you are. I don't think I'm smart. I failed 3 times for universities. I never succeed in past good examinations. But the thing we do is I never give up. I fail, I try again, I fail, I try again, I fail, I try again until we succeed. So it's not Alibaba was not made last month. It was made 18 years ago. 18 years is a short time, but it's a long time for us. We work much harder than most of the people. So these days, when I see the Vietnam young people, you are happy, I'm happy. I see so many people happy on the street in the evening. Oh, they're dancing, you know, they're kicking and all great, lot of funny games. Can you continue to be happy like that? Think about your future. Think about some business. Think about using the Vietnam, because today Vietnam, I saw 54% of the people have mobile phones. But a lot of people probably spend time on playing games online. You should start play the best game online that is making money doing business. Try to do e-commerce. Try to sell things online. Try to buy things online. Try to communicate with people online. Because in the future, most of the business, there will be no made in China, there will be no made in Vietnam, there will be no made in America. There will be made in internet. You may buy things from this country, assembly here, and sell the other country. Please make full use of the internet. Get information, get knowledge, make friends. Everything should be on the internet. And the other thing I don't like about Vietnam, which I want to do something together with young people here, is about online payment, the cash. I found that they have a mobile phone, they have a lot of cash, that Vietnam. We should kill all the cash. We should use a mobile phone payment. And I think, this is what I believe, that in 10 years, when you have a mobile phone or other devices, you can buy globally, you can sell globally, you can deliver products globally, you can pay globally, and you can travel globally. And don't worry too much about artificial intelligence is going to take away people's job. People will always be wiser than the machines. But if you do not work hard, if you do not learn, if you do not work with, follow, embrace the change, you will have problems. So this is what I say. Vietnam, 93, 94 million people, 54% of the internet users, and only 4 million people shopping online. Over 90% of the transactions are on cash, right? You don't have a credit card system, you don't have a mobile payment system, you have a not good logistic systems, you don't have even a good marketplaces. Oh, people say, impossible to do business in Vietnam. Let me tell you, this is the best opportunity for you. If everything is ready, why they need you? Because all these things are not ready, that is why you can make full use of the opportunity to build it up. 18 years ago, China, there's no logistic. People say, no logistic, you cannot do e-commerce. There's no logistic, we say, we make it. People say, there's no payment, we make it. There's no marketplaces, we make it. We will not make it within one day. We prepare for make it in 15 years. So I'm happy to hear. I had a great discussion with the Prime Minister this morning, Deputy Prime Minister, Governor of the Central Bank. They all support the young people. They all support the infrastructure for Vietnam to do e-commerce. And Alibaba will do anything to support. The most important is working with you, young people. Without you, there will be no opportunity. Thank you. So we're going to have a dialogue, and if you have any questions, I will be happy to answer.
Yeah, so inspiration, yeah? Great.
Thank you.
Yeah, thank you very much.
Thank you.
Thank you very much for coming to Vietnam to share your thoughts with the youth. And now is the Q&A sessions.
Yep.
Yeah, may I invite Ngô Khánh Linh, Miss Ngô Khánh Linh, where are you? Yeah, come up. Yeah, here sit in the center. Oh, she's...
That's in the middle?
Yeah.
Come on. You're the chair.
Yes.
Yeah, please, sit in the middle.
Thank you. Please.
Come on. Yep.
Yeah, please introduce yourself, and you got the great honors to ask first questions.
Hello. Hello, Mr. Bing. Hello, Dr. Ma. And good afternoon, the audience. Um, First of all, I want to welcome you to Vietnam, and I hope you will have a great time during your visit in our country. And my name is Ngô Khánh Linh. I'm 20 years old. I'm a third-year student at Diplomatic Academy of Vietnam. It is my pleasure to be here today and to talk to you and represent all the students and have an opportunity to meet you and Dr. Ma. I have watched a lot of your interviews on the internet, on YouTube, since I was in high school. And I'm very impressed.
Thank you.
I know you are a man of great enterprise. You do have a strong influence on other people, especially us, the young people. And I bet you've got quite some experience there. And today, we're so lucky to have you here. Someone next to me, extremely qualified, wants to share everything you have learned throughout your career. And I know your time is very precious. So I will go straight into the questions, if you don't mind.
Yep.
So the first question I want to ask you.
Oh.
This is the question that yep. I've collected from okay. other people. So the first question is, which moments in life have shaped the man like you are today and the philosopher? The one who is operating a digital economy of hundreds of billions of dollars and hundreds of millions of users. Can you tell us?
Who changed my mindset?
Which moments in life okay. have shaped you as the man you are today?
Which moment of today? Oh, okay, now, let me first say that the day when I invited 17 partners in my apartment 18 years ago, I said one thing to them, that if we succeed, 80% of the young people in China will be succeed. Because we are not smart, we are not rich, we don't have technology. The only thing is we believe the future. We want to do little by little. And what shaped me today, which movement, I don't know. But there are so many movements. It's not the success. It's not the thing that will succeed shaped us. It's the movement that we failed raising money. We failed in projects. We failed in partnering with people. We failed in making money. These things make us even stronger. So young people, remember this thing. Don't be disappointing when you are rejected. Don't be disappointing. Don't be sad when you fail. This is the test of your life. If you pass that test, you get stronger. And I had a lot of sad moment. I said again, one day, like early days, I was so frustrated because every project I did was, I failed. And I watched a movie, the English movie called Forrest Gump. I learned life is like a box of chocolate. You never know what you're going to get. Stay foolish. Stick to your dreams. Be patient. Work with the people. Solve problems little by little. So this is all I did. And that shaped me. And I know before me, before Alibaba, there are a lot of big problems waiting for us to solve. Not a lot of good things waiting for us to celebrate. It's always bad things that we should be prepared.
Great.
Wonderful. Very good.
Thank you.
Yeah, actually you said exactly what Vietnamese, I think Chinese social talking saying, failure is the mother of success.
Yeah.
Yeah, now is a question from audience. Yeah.
Please, the audience, please raise your hand if you want to ask.
You got a mobile.
Hello, Jackman. I'm a student from Academy of Finance. So I have a question for you. We know your parents are idols, and one of several things you inherited is your sense of humor. Your speeches in a few summits I saw on YouTube are so humorous and attractive. So which benefit you get from this characteristic, and can you try to make audience laugh right now?
Interesting questions.
Yeah.
After long days,
let me tell you one thing. Every day I have a lot of problems. If cry can help me to solve this problem, I will cry every day. But cry only make me happy, my team unhappy. So the thing I do is try to make myself happy. I said I warm up my left hand with my right hand. I have to make sure that a good entrepreneur learn how to be humorous, how to face the challenges. I don't believe in Superman. I believe the super fighting spirit of don't give up. So I cannot make, I'm not a talk show person. I cannot make other people laugh, but I always try to make myself laugh.
As at least you make me laugh.
Thank you
me
for
too.
The questions. I never made a question like that, so let me think about next time.
Thank you. Actually, I would like also ask you one question. I know you are very visionary, and you are now very looking far away, and you're talking about electronic world trade platform. What you think that will be such important for the digital world in future? Can you explain to the audience what stand for and how you move it forward?
Okay. I think past 30, 50 years, the globalization made world very good. But unfortunately, globalization, only 60,000 big companies benefit from globalization. 99% of the small business, developing countries, don't have any opportunity. So I think we should build up a system supporting small business import-export. We should build up a platform then helping young people like Ling can buy anywhere, sell anywhere. This is what we think we should do. So I'm building up a platform called Electronic World Trade Platform. With this platform that everybody can buy, everybody can sell, everybody can pay, everybody can travel. We want to make sure that this opportunity is for young people. This opportunity is for small business. So we want to make Vietnam also be part of that network, and all the young people can benefit. This is what we discuss.
Thank you for your
Thank
question.
You.
Answer, excuse me. So, the next questions, anyone? Oh, lots of
yeah,
hands.
Yeah, a lot yeah. of hands.
Yeah.
Hello. My name is Nguyen Phuong Anh, and I'm a student in Diplomatic Academy of Vietnam.
Oh.
Yeah. Firstly, I want to thank for your wonderful speech and what you have said is really inspiring. Secondly, I want to ask you a question. I know that success, one of your reasons leads to your success comes from the relationship you build inside your company. And you have said that always let your employee come to work with a smile. So could you please send us some advice how you inspire your workers and keep them motivated every day? Thanks so much.
Thank you so much. Yeah, Diplomatic Academy. The best diplomatic is trade, business. When trade stops, war starts. Trade can make the world very peaceful. When you buy things from another country, you are respect the other country's culture. When you're exporting your products to the other country, that means the other country accept you. So I think to keep this world of peaceful, we have to do business and trade cross nations. About your questions, I don't want my employees come to the company with smile and leave the company with crying. I want to do the opposite. The logo, Alibaba logo, is a smiling face. The day when I designed this Alibaba logo, I said, I want my customer, my colleagues, my shareholders, when they go home, they have Alibaba smile. How can you make your people smile and be happy in the company? Very important is that you should be making sure the work, the job they do in the company are meaningful. Meaningful to the society, meaningful to themselves, meaningful to community, meaningful to their people. So everything Alibaba doing, we have to ask ourselves one question. Is this thing really helpful to the society? Is this thing really helpful to our customers? Is this something that we really want to do? If you answer these questions right, if you do things like that, you'll be happy. And also, join Alibaba is very difficult, but leave Alibaba is very simple. If you want to leave, you can leave anytime. But if you want to join the company, it is very difficult. So, a lot of companies do the opposite. Very easy to go in, very difficult to come out. So, tell me, what is the place that is easy to go in, difficult to come out? That's a prison. You know prison? Easy to go in, difficult to come out. So you have to make your company, it's like free, young people, great ideas, making progress every day, people will be happy. So this is, it's money is important. Without money, nobody happy. But only money cannot be make you real happy in your heart. You have to have the achievement.
Excellent.
Thank you.
Bravo.
Thank you.
Next question, please.
Anyone? Lots of hands.
Yeah.
Okay, maybe the person's very close. Yeah, yeah, with the box. What? But don't bring box to here, yeah? You just questions. Yeah, stay on the place and please ask.
Yeah, the phone's.
We are Zagma!
Thank you.
We are Zagma! I love Zagma.
Okay, thank you.
I want to give a gift of letter. Oh letter. Oh letter.
Okay. Thank you. You are love Jack Ma.
I love Jack.
We got the point. Thank you. Stay here. Stay there.
What is your question?
Okay.
Oh letter. Oh letter.
Okay, maybe hello. I change you to another question. Hello, maybe hello. You ask hello. Some questions?
Hello.
Yeah, thank you.
Hello. Hello.
Thank you very much.
Hello.
So
I'll be waiting for your gift later. Thank you.
Yeah, thank you. We thank got you. The gift. Yeah. Yeah.
Thank you. Hello. Can I have a question?
Thank you. Thank you.
Okay.
Really loves you.
Thank you.
Really loves you.
Hello.
Yeah.
My name is Phạm Đức Vượng and I'm studying at Diplomatic Academy of Vietnam. And it's a great honor for me to be here today, and I have one question for you. As I know, in 1999, you with your 70 friends had to work together to establish and develop your company Alibaba, which has great success. So can you share with us some advices on how to find and choose reliable and good co-founders? Thank you.
Okay. How to choose co-founders. My advice to many people here that when you looking for partners, try not to invite your friends into your company. Right. Most people in this world, we can be friends, but we can never be partners. My way is that I don't like my friends join the company. But when people join my company, I try my best to be friends with them. That's simpler and easier. Finding partners, you are looking for people believe the same vision. You are looking for people joining you not because it's going to make a lot of money, because we will work this thing together and make things happen. You have to find the people, not the best people. There's no, as I said, there's no best people. You can find it immediately. The best people is always you work it together for several years. You know each other, you support each other. A good partner that I have, we quarrel a lot, we fight a lot, but we never, ever destroy the vision together. We share the same value, we share the same vision, and we share the same mission. On the way here, for past 18 years, I have a lot of people join the company. I have a lot of people left the company. It's okay. Come and go. When they leave, we are friends. When they join the company, we are partners. We are colleagues. So it's not easy to have good partners. Good partners is not to find. Good partners, you work together, you become partner. Partner is trying to make each other, not to fail. So what is a teamwork? Teamwork is for three people is a team. We don't want the link to fail. We don't want Mr. Bing to fail. That is called a teamwork. So doing business, you will learn a lot of life experience. And this kind of life experience, the bigger the company is, the more you will learn. And you have to learn these things. Enjoy this failure. Enjoy this partnership. Enjoy this sad moment, happy moment together. So that's what I say.
Thank you. But Jack, do you know that your advice make me sad, because I found company about 30 years ago with all my friends, 13 my friends.
You know,
and we still working together today, and we fighting so much.
Yeah. It's very painful when friends work together. Easy at the beginning, very painful on the way. I have seen hundreds of companies, they become friends and later they hate each other. And then somebody say, well, because you're my partner, so let me, I give you something to do and I do this, even get worse. So the way how to handle that, if you're a leader, if you really become the leader and the founder, you have to see further than your team. You have to have a broader chest, embrace any kinds of people. And you have this resistance. Any failure comes, any problem comes, you have to face it. So a leader is a very lonely.
Yeah. Maybe your turn.
So my next question is for you. I want to look at the phone. I know that you did suffer from a pretty tough time. You said that you got rejected from KFC. You failed 3 times the entrance, the university, and you got rejected from every company after your graduation. So I'm wondering what makes you standing up and moving on and be the man like you are today.
Yeah, of course, when you are rejected, I feel very sad. I cannot tell my parents. My parents came back and said, hey, you know, everybody joined, you are the only guy rejected again. Well, now I think probably God does not want me to join the other company. He wants me to build up a company for myself. So there's no option, right? There's no chance. So that is why today I spent a lot of time with young people and students and tell them that how I go through. Go back home, sleep, tomorrow try again. There's no choice. Let me tell you, 80% of the people in this world have the same thing. If Jack Ma today is not CEO of Alibaba, like nobody, right? So nobody will read my story. Today, because we founded Alibaba, we succeed, people realize, wow, you know, you are good, huh? You've been rejected so many times. We are the same. The only thing is, I never give up. Most people give up. If you give up, you have no chance. If you don't give up, you still have chance.
Great. Yep. Okay, actually, time soon finish. And you had two last questions, yeah. Oh, so many hands.
Last questions, everyone.
Yes. Hi, everyone. My name is Lin, and I'm from APT University. Yeah. Thank you, Jack Ma, for staying here and give us a chance to meet and talk to you. Dear Dr. Ma, my question is, you have said about the whole business, but for you in Alibaba, what are the key factors that make you in your company success, and especially for Vietnamese people, the Jews, and can you give us some advice in when you get the trouble, if you have to ask someone, who will be the person you will ask? Thank you.
When you got in trouble, whom you asked?
When I'm in trouble, who will I ask?
Yes.
Yeah, that's a very good question. When I start my business, my company is very small. I ask my colleagues. When my company is getting bigger, I ask my colleagues. Today, my company is that big. When I have a problem, I ask my colleagues. This is called teamwork. We teamwork does not only work job together. When I have a problem, I ask my team. I never hide anything secret in my pocket. Everything I know, I share with the team. And I do the same. I hope my team, if they have problem, they ask me. We discuss openly and frankly. Of course, today is different. Alibaba is so big now. Our size last year is almost as big as number 21 country in the world. This year, our GMV, our sales is like number 20 or 19 country in the world. When it is so big, there is no place I can learn. So I read books, I travel around the world, I'm meeting so many prime ministers, presidents, great business leaders, artists. I talk to them, listen to them, and I think. And then I share with my team. As I said, nobody is a superman. It's not that you make the team succeed. It's the team make you succeed. It's the people who working together make you succeed. So this is what, when I have a problem, I think about it. I share with my team. If I know my team cannot figure this out, I have a sleep. I wake up tomorrow morning.
And ask team again.
Yeah. Yep. In the past 18 years, there is no problem that I think I should commit to suicide. There's always a way out. There is always solution for future. There is always way to tomorrow. The only thing is that you may not have it, but you have to find it out with the team.
Great.
Right.
Please, last questions.
Last questions. Hello. Who? The last questions.
Hello.
I see a very beautiful lady. Yeah, we give two ladies.
Hello, Mr. Jack Ma. It's such an honor to talk to you today. My name is Fong. I'm in my second year at Foreign Trade University. Thank you. So here's my question. What do you think about two options? Starting up early when I have passion, enthusiasm, and I dare to risk, but I lack experience. Or starting up late when I've got lots of experience, but settling down makes me like harder to take risk. So what is your decision in this situation? Thank you.
Do you got the understand?
I did not get the first.
Yeah, start early.
Yeah.
Or get experience first and then start.
Okay. Life is an experience. To me, as if you're a student, the best business for you is spend full time study, be a good student in the university. And then, okay, let me answer the question this way. My advice to many people, a lot of young people came to me for advice. I say, if you are 20 to 30 years old, you should find a good boss, not necessarily a good company. A good boss is better than a good company. A lot of good companies do not have a lot of bosses. Find a good boss, learn from him. If you are 30 to 40 years old, you want to do something yourself, just do it. When you are 40 to 50 years old, you have to do something that you are good at. After so many years, you have to do something you really love it, you can do good, do better. When you are 50 to 60 years old, you should give an opportunity to young people, develop, train young people. When you are over 60 years old, spend the time with your grandchildren. But any time is a good time for being entrepreneur. If you start early, have experience, and then go back to study, which is fine. I like that. This is the way we do it. I also do that. I graduated from university. I taught in the university for 6 years as a teacher. Then I started my business. When I'm in the university, I spend most of the time working in the students' union, support students. I was the chairman of the students' union of my university. I was also the chairman of the students' union of my city. I spent a lot of time understanding people. I spent a lot of time helping people. By the way, I discussed with Ling just now at the back. We know we have EQ, IQ, and I also want to say you should have LQ, the Q of love. These Qs are very important. If you want to be successful, you should have EQ. EQ is to understand people, to support people, work with people. But IQ is to understand the knowledge to do things better. If you want to be successful, a lot of people should have EQ, high EQ. But if you do not want to fail, you should have IQ. IQ makes you do things with great logic, with great knowledge, so you will not lose quickly. Many people easy come, easy go. They get this opportunity and losing the opportunity very quick. So get opportunity is not easy, but losing opportunity, you feel very bad. Not losing opportunity, you should have a Q. Why you should have the LQ? A lot of people made a lot of money, but never got respected by the people. If you one day want to be respected, you should have the Q of love. That is LQ. That is care for the others. And this is what my advice.
Wonderful. Thank you for your those tips.
Yep.
Maybe the ladies. Come up.
The beautiful lady in black.
Yeah, come up. Please. Yeah, take the microphone. Last questions. We have the very short time.
That is
so honored. Thank you. Hello, Mr. Jack Ma. My name is Lan Phuong, and I'm an actress. I think maybe I'm the only one, the actress here, and I'm a fan of you, and my brother is a fan of you too.
Thank you.
And I have a question, my question and his question.
Okay.
Because now, and I know, we know that you want to motivate the e-commerce and the mobile payment, so our question is, what do you think about the future of the Bitcoin?
Of the future of the Bitcoin?
Yes. Yeah, so that's what my brother is learning and doing and trading. So yeah, please.
Okay. What, you are actress?
Yes, I'm an actress.
Oh, I'm an actor now. Thank you.
And I'm so honored. And thank you so much for letting me on stage.
Thank you
so much.
Thank you.
So I stay here to hear your answer, or I go back to my seat?
Thank you.
Please.
Thank you.
Thank you. Thank you. Yeah, the beautiful actress.
Indeed.
I want to prove one thing. People not good looking like me can also be an actor. That is, I'm trying my best to be a singer, an actor, and a painter. In my life, I want to try a lot of experience. And I respect an actor and actors, not easy, because after 12 days shooting a movie, I know it's not easy to be a good actor. So you will see my movie very soon.
Yeah, I know that movie. Yeah. Kung Fu, right? Yeah.
The question about Bitcoin, honestly, I'm not that big fan of Bitcoins. But I pay special attention to the cashless society, blockchain technology. Bitcoin, the thing I want to know is that what value, what things that the Bitcoin can bring to the society. But behind the Bitcoin, the technology itself really very powerful. So my job and Alibaba Alipay's job is trying to making sure that the world will move into a cashless society. The society can make everybody equal, make everybody inclusive to get the money they need, and making sure it's sustainable, inclusive, and transparent. I hate corruption. I don't have opportunity, it's okay. But I don't want somebody through dirty way take away my opportunity. This is why we want a cashless society. But Bitcoin, we watch it very carefully. I will not say I'm a fan of Bitcoins. I'm always also as curious as you are. And I don't think I'm expert on that. I don't pretend I know. There's one thing that I want to share with all of you one day when you do business or do whatever. If you don't know, it's not shameful. But if you don't know, but you pretend you know, it is very shameful. I don't know about Bitcoins.
Please ask your team.
Okay,
I see a lot of questions, and maybe Jack, you turn back someday to answer the question.
Yeah, yeah.
Okay, but sorry, time is over. Thank you very much for all your activities. Thank you.
Thank you. Ladies and gentlemen, thank you for Mr. Jack Ma for sharing a lot of experience and inspiring us for today.
Thank you.
To remark this memorable moment, we would like to invite Mr. Lê Quốc Phong, alternate member of Center Executive Committee, First Secretary of Youth Union, to give flowers to Jack Ma.
Thank you.
Yeah. Oh.
And we also invite all of government leaders, youth union organizer, sponsor, go to stage and take photograph with Mr. Jack Ma. Thank you for attending today. We wish you all the best. Thank you.
Thank you so much, and I hope everybody have a bright future, and don't give up. Thank you.
Yeah.
Chúng tôi xin trân trọng kính mời các đồng chí lãnh đạo, mời anh Phi Long ạ, anh Phan Đức Thắng ạ, cùng lên chụp ảnh lưu niệm với ngài Jack Ma.
Thank you. Oh yeah, sure.
Yeah.
Thank you.
Mời anh Phong.
Thank you. Thank you. Thank you.
Tiếp theo xin mời nhóm làm phim ạ. Xin mời nhóm làm phim lên chụp ảnh lưu niệm với ngài Jack Ma để kỷ niệm ạ.
Thank you.
One photos.